Good morning, good morning. Happy Tuesday to you. So I hope you are doing awesome. Hope you are having a great day. Hopefully you had a great weekend. Hopefully you got lots of rest and time with family just on the Memorial Day weekend. I had a great weekend. It was awesome spending time with the family. Didn't have any weddings, and I got to lead again at the church on Sunday. So it was just an overall awesome day, but I'm excited to get back into it. I did work yesterday. I just decided not to vlog. I just had some stuff I wanted to wrap up. So today I'm back. Today is Tuesday. It's my shorter day. Gonna get right to work, starting a little earlier than normal today. And let's just get this day started. Today's a very important day. So really excited about this new project that we're doing with a local company in Allentown. And we're just talking details today about when we're actually shooting. So gotta make a quick phone call. I'll be back with you in a second. Got a package. Seems like an awfully big box to have another box inside. To have more bubble wrap inside. Got my A7S II back in perfect timing to sell it. That's like my absolute favorite thing to see. Thank you for your order. I am feeling great. Even though I love buying new stuff, I love purchasing new things, selling things, I love going through all that. I hate the process that it puts my brain through, because for the last 2 weeks, ever since I bought this GH5, my mind's just been going 100 miles an hour, and all I think about is what is the best setup for what I want to do. And I finally decided, and the purchase has finally been made, and I am going with my initial thought process the minute I touch this GH5, and that is that I'm getting rid of my Sony stuff. I'm getting rid of my A7S IIs, I'm getting rid of all my Sony lenses, and I'm going to all GH5s with Olympus Pro lenses. It's done. Sony, I'm out. You see, it's not that the A7S IIs aren't outstanding cameras. I will never sit here and say, like, if you use an A7S II, it's junk. It is an incredible camera on so many aspects. I just realized that I was sacrificing a lot of things that actually are really important to me in the scheme of what I do on a wedding day and how I run my business and the commercial side of what I do, that for me, and this is just for me, it made more sense to go with the entire GH5 setup for so many reasons. And I'm not going to bore you with all the details again with this video. I just wanted to let you know what I decided. And that's really great because I also have more dual purpose stuff that I can use these GH5s for, like vlogging and like filming my own content, but yet I also get tons of the really great perks of what I really want these cameras for, which is my wedding work and my commercial and business work. So for me, they just seem like the best possible camera I can spend money on right now, and I'm just really pumped to get all the new gear and all the new lenses tomorrow and to use them. I cannot wait. Electrify it, you make the dark. You don't think I need it on? Daddy. You gonna turn it off? Well, that wraps up the majority of my work afternoon, morning-ish. Now it's time to hang out with Gracie for a couple hours, and then we'll get back to work when she goes to bed. You know, it's family time. Come on. For me, without a doubt, the toughest thing is not getting myself to be motivated to work, but staying focused on one thing. It's so easy for me to get distracted by notifications on my phone and email and social media. There's so much stuff that it's sometimes really hard to just stay focused on one thing. For example, when I'm editing a wedding film, locking down and staying focused on just that without being distracted is what gets really tough for me. Because you see, I don't have a problem actually getting myself to be motivated to work. I love working, I love hustling, I love grinding, I love doing doing all that kind of stuff. The problem is just staying focused on one thing. And I'm curious how you deal with it. If you're a creative, if you're someone that sits in front of a computer and does something for a long period of time, how do you manage that? I'm really trying to find that balance right now because I want to be better at it. I know there will be times that I'm going to stop working and I'm going to work on something else, or I'm going to check an email, or I'm going to do this, or I'm going to do that, but I'm just really trying to find how I can do better at when I'm actually focusing on something specifically, getting rid of the other notifications. And it's hard for me to just say, okay, I'll turn off all my email and I'll turn my phone on Do Not Disturb, because there's always clients that are getting in touch with me and new couples that are looking to book me. It's just hard to balance that. So I'd love to hear your thoughts. How do you balance kind of the busyness of not getting distracted as at the same time you're trying to work hard? And with that said, this is one of the distractions, the camera. But I tend to just take a break every once in a while, just turn the camera on and share my thoughts. We'll get back to work now. Well, mission accomplished. Finished the film, just got to do color correcting and all that stuff tomorrow, so I'm really excited about that, and I am super pumped about tomorrow because I am getting all my new gear. Huge decision. Excited to tell you more about it, but for now, it's after 10 o'clock. I gotta edit this sometime, I think, so good night.